Hi there. In this lesson, I wanted to talk about tapping across multiple different strings. So in previous lessons, I've taught you how to do things like... just different patterns to do on one string. But you can do those same, you can use those same ideas to play across multiple different strings and really do even more than you were doing before, do kind of more cool patterns. So what it looks like is just this kind of thing. That at its most basic, you can also take it much more difficult to like... I'm without distortion right now, so it's a little quiet, but that's the general idea. Where once you start working on these different things, I'm playing across multiple different strings, you can really free up some new options. So the idea is exactly the same as tapping on one string. The only difference is when you're playing on new strings, you just have to start the note at some point. And the easiest way to do this is to do it with your tapping hand. So for example, I'm going to play a major scale, a 3-note per string major scale going down, and you're going to see that I'm going to start each new string by tapping with my right hand. So it's going to look like this. I'm playing that. It's just a B major scale starting on the high E, the fourth of the scale. With each of these, what I'm doing is I'm just tapping on the highest note, pulling off the note below it, and then pulling off to the last note. Tap, pull off, pull off, tap, pull off, pull off, tap, pull off, pull off. The other thing to do is you can start with a note with a finger on your left hand, so like this, going up the scale. As you can see with that one, I'm starting by tapping with my first finger on my left hand on the note, doing a hammer on to the second note, and then tapping with my right hand. So, you know, kind of like hammer, hammer, tap, hammer, hammer, tap, hammer, hammer, tap, hammer, hammer, tap. And that's a general idea. It's exactly the same as tapping on one string, it's just you gotta start the note at some point. A few things you gotta realize when you're doing this, and you gotta take into account, is when you're playing on multiple different strings, when you leave a string, it's going to have a tendency to ring. To kind of give you an example, I'll do it going up. You can hear how the lower strings after I'm done playing them will still be ringing. It's actually really bad with distortion. It's just like it'll be even more distracting because the notes won't gel together as well as they do clean. So you got to make sure when you leave a string to somehow mute it. And the easiest ways I find are just if I'm going from a high string to a lower string, you can use kind of the bottoms of your finger the same way you mute like a chord. Use like fingers on your left hand to mute the higher strings. Or if I'm going up, you can either use, you know, like the tops of your pads of either hand, or you can use your thumb to keep the lower strings from ringing. So yeah, that's the general idea. The next lesson I'm going to talk about just some different patterns you can do and how you can spice it up. So I hope you found this useful. Thanks.